Hi all, I am Sabu Joseph. Welcome to SVJ Academy. In this video, we are going to discuss about the new scheme of EPFO under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Rozgar Yojana, ABRY. The EPFO announced this scheme on 31st December 2020 through a circular. We can see what are the criteria, benefits and everything of this scheme. The central government on 12th November 2020 announced the Atmanirbhar Bharat 3 package containing several stimulus measures to revive the economy and provide relief to stressed sectors. As part of the package, Atmanirbhar Bharat Rozgar Yojana scheme is announced to incentivize creation of new employment and restoration of loss of employment during the COVID-19 pandemic. So the main object of this scheme is to create new employment. Then see what are the objectives of this scheme. This scheme proposes to incentivize employers registered with the EPFO for giving employment to new employees and re-employing persons from low wage brackets who lost their jobs during COVID-19 pandemic. The central government will pay both the employees and employers' share. This is the beauty. The central government will pay both the employees and employer share of contribution payable under the EPF and MB Act, or only the employee's share depending on the employment strength of the establishment, directly to the universal account number of eligible employee maintained by the EPFO. What is the validity period of this scheme? When it will commence and when it will end? The scheme stands commenced from 1st October 2020 and shall remain open for 30th June 2021. So the scheme will start with effect from 1st October 2020. The EPFO has announced this scheme on 31st December 2020, but it will be stands commenced from 1st October 2020. The benefits shall be available for a period of 24 months from the date of registration of new employee, not later than 30th June 2023. Here in the scheme, what is meant by new employee? Here, new employee means any employee drawing wages less than rupees 15,000 per month who has not working in any establishment and did not have a universal account number prior to 1st October 2020, who joins employment in any establishment on or after 1st October 2020 up to 30th June 2021 and who is allotted Aadhaar validated UAN. Any EPF member already allotted with the UAN who made exit from employment during the period from 1st March 2020 to 30th September 2020 from any establishment, such a date of exit is recorded in UAN, and who joins in any establishment on or after 1st October 2020 and up to 30th June 2021. Only these employees will be considered as the definition of new employee. For availing this scheme, some reference base is given. That means the scheme will commence from 1st October 2020 and the reference base of employees will be considered as per the ECR return filed by the establishment during the month of September 2020. So, during the month of September 2020, the number of employees for whom the employer has remitted contributions through ECR before commencing this scheme shall be taken as reference base for determining the eligibility of an establishment. In the case of new establishments getting registered with the EPFO between 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021, the reference base of workers will be treated as zero. Then what is the eligibility conditions of establishments? Three types of eligibility conditions are given. The first one is employee less than or equal to 50. The second one is employee in between 51 to 1000. And the third one is employee more than 1000 in numbers. If the establishment is under the first reference base, that is employee strength less than or equal to 50, such establishments have to employ minimum of 2 employees from 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021. This is the first criteria. If your establishment have less than or equal to employees base, that establishment has to give a job opportunity of at least 2 employees from October to June 2021. Under second reference base, that is employee strength between 51 to 1000, such establishments have to employ minimum of 5 employees from October to June 2021. So these benefits can be availed only for new employees appointed from 1st of October 2022 30th June 2021. In the first reference base, the establishment has to appoint at least 2 employees, and under the second reference, the establishment has to appoint at least 5 employees. If the establishment have appointed 1 employee under reference 1, that establishment is not eligible for the scheme. Under the second case, the establishment has to provide at least 5 employments. If the establishment has given 4 employments, that establishment will not come under the scheme. One more important point is, the already registered establishments must continue to retain the number of employees taken as reference base of employees for availing the assistance under this scheme for any wage month. That means, suppose your establishment have 45 employees during the month of September and you have appointed 3 employees during the month of October. Now it is coming to 48 employees. But during the month of October, 5 employees left the job. Now the total strength will be less than the ECR filed by the month of September. So your establishment will be ineligible under this scheme. So we have to retain in the number of employees during the month of September up to the scheme ends. Now we've seen the eligibility criteria for establishments. What are the eligibility criteria for employees? The new employee should be registered for the scheme during the period from 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021 by employer of eligible establishments. The second one is, the new employee should have a valid Aadhaar number, and that Aadhaar should be linked to the universal account number. The third is, the benefits under this scheme shall be paid for the wage month in which he continues to be in any eligible establishment, subject to a period of maximum 24 months from the date of registration of an employee. The fourth one is, the eligible new employee under this scheme shall become ineligible if his or her monthly wages exceeds 15,000 rupees at any point of time during the scheme period. So the employee who is getting a less than 15,000 rupees salary or wage in a month is eligible for this scheme. And one more thing is, already the government has introduced another scheme, PMRPY. Under this scheme, the central government has paid both the employee and the employer share of contributions. So these are the eligibility criteria for the employees. Let's see the amount of benefits. This scheme will be available for 24 months from the date of registration of new employee. The central government will provide subsidy for 24 wage months. Here also some more classifications are given. For establishments employing up to and including 1000 employees contributing EPF and with the UIN number, in the month of September 2020, the employers and employees share of contribution as per the statutory rates applicable to establishments subject to maximum of 25% of wages. The central government will provide subsidy for 24 wage months in respect to eligible new employees. Here also some more classifications are given. The first is, for establishments employing up to 1000 employees. For such establishments, the 12% of employee share and the 12% of employee share will be given by the central government as subsidy. So total 24% will give the central government as subsidy. And the second one is, if the establishments employing more than 1,000 employees. During the month of September 2020, the EPF contributors in an establishment is more than 10,000. In such a cases, the central government will give only 12% of employees' share only. The employer share will not be given. Now let's see what are the procedures for availing this benefit. The eligible establishments shall first register the establishment under this scheme, disclosing the reference base of employees through a link in the employer's login page. Coming to the EPFO portal, login with our username and password. Let's see how can we register the establishment to the ABRY scheme, EPF portal. Here we can see a new menu, ABRY. Under the ABRY menu, we can see two more submenus, establishment registration and member registration. Open the establishment registration. We can see three questions. The total number of employees less than 50. The second one is the total number of employees 51 to 1,000, and the third one is total number of employees more than 1,000. So select the applicable reference base, the first, second or third, but it should be matched with the previous ECR, that is the ECR of September 2020. In the September 2020 ECR, our employee strength is 45. Suppose our employee strength is 45 and now we are selecting the option 51 to 1,000 employees, that will leads to ineligibility. So select the proper reference base and accept the conditions, then submit. Now you will get, you have successfully submitted the declaration. Here you can see the declaration, the establishment is registered with the scheme. After registering the establishment with the scheme, go to the second menu, member registration. Here we have to add the newly appointed employees from 1st October to June 2021. Now already 2 months, so already we have completed 3 months, October, November and December. So if any employee appointed during the month of October, November or December and they have enrolled with the EPFO, we have to add that employee here. So we have to give the details of the employee and upload that file here. So click on the instructions. You can see, click here to download the sample bulk upload file. Here download the sample file. It is a text file, not an Excel file. It is a text file only. Here the format is given only UAN. For registering the employee to the ABRY scheme, you just give the UAN number. You can remove the details mentioned here and just enter the UAN number of that employee. That's all. You can enter the UAN number of employees one by one and save the file. That file can be uploaded here. Now that employee will be added to the ABRY scheme. Then when we are filing the ECR on coming months, it will be reflected on the challan. Now we completed the how to register the establishment and how to register the member. Both we have completed. Everything we discussed in a detailed manner. Now let's see, in short, only some points we have to remember. The first point is, the scheme will commence with effect from 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021. The second is, the benefit shall be available for a period of 24 months from the date of registration of new employee, not less than 30th June 2000, not later than 30th June 2023. So the scheme validity is for 2 years, which will be, the maximum date will be 30th June 2023. The third one is, if the establishment is under first reference base, that is the employee strength less than or equal to 50, such establishments have to employ minimum 2 new employees between 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021. If the establishment is under second reference base, that is the employee strength between 51 to 1,000, such establishments have to employ minimum of 5 new employees between 1st October 2020 to 30th June 2021. The already registered establishments must continue to retain the number of employees for availing the assistance under this scheme for any wage month. The new employee should have a valid Aadhaar and that Aadhaar should be linked with the universal account number. The next one is the new employee whose salary less than 15,000 is eligible under this scheme. For establishments employing up to 1,000 employees contributing EPF in wage month of September 2020, the employer's share and employee's share of contribution as per the statutory rate of 12%, that is 24%, will be borne by the central government. So all the employers who is giving a new employment can avail this scheme. So first of all, they have to go to the portal, login with their username and password, go to the menu ABRY, or on payment link, you can see the same. Under payments, click on ECR filing. When we are open the ECR filing, you can see the same information: Atmanirbhar Bharat Rozgar Yojana, establishment registration and member registration. Both we can see. From here also, we can register the establishment and member. So this is a very good attractive scheme announced by the central government under Atmanirbhar Rozgar Yojana scheme. All please avail this scheme by all the employers and employees and provide more employment. If you really like the information, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Don't forget to enable the bell icon. You will get all the important notifications. So many videos relating to income tax, GST, ESI, EPF, TDS and everything available in the channel. Please go to the channel page under the playlist. You can see all these videos. All the practical sessions and the theoretical classes also available. Most of the classes are under practical study, live filing and everything. So please go to the channel. And if you really like, please share to your colleagues and your circles. We can see on next video with a new topic. Till then, bye.